Hello friends, welcome back to our channel, and today we'll be studying index of orthodontic treatment needs. People seek orthodontic treatment for two reasons. One is for looks and the other one is for function. So before starting ahead, let's have a look at orthodontics. Orthodontics is a science and a branch of dentistry which deals with the development of the face, development of the dentition, and prevention and correction of any occlusal abnormality. So approximately 60% of the people are seen with crowding, especially in the lower anterior region. And 15 to 20% of the people are seen with class 2 division 1 malocclusion, which we have discussed in the previous video, in which the maxillary anterior teeth are proclined, and 10% of the people are seen with class 2 division 2, in which the upper anterior teeth are retroclined and there is reduced overjet. In class 2 division 1, there is increased in the overjet, and 3% of the people are seen with the class 3 malocclusion, in which the mandibular anterior mandible is proclined. So the orthodontic treatment need comprises of two components. One is the dental health component and the other one is the aesthetic component. An index was used by Sweden Dental Health Board, and this index was used to determine the amount of finances that was given by the state for any orthodontic treatment need. So it has five categories for the treatment need, starting from very little to very great. The aesthetic component is based on a series of 10 photographs of the front view of the labial aspect of the class of malocclusion, and a score was determined based on the photographs. It is divided into five categories. Grade 1 is none, grade 5 being very great requirement for orthodontic treatment, and a patient's grade is determined by recording the single worst feature of their malocclusion. Grade 1 is extremely minor malocclusion with displacement of less than 1 millimeter of the teeth, and there is no requirement for orthodontic treatment. And let's jump onto the table to make it easier for you. There is an increase in the overjet ranging from 3.6 to 6 mm. With the competent lips, both the lips meet each other at rest for grade 2. For grade 3, it is same 3.6 to 6 mm. But with the incompetent lips, lips don't meet each other for grade 3. Grade 4, it is much higher, 6.1 to 9 mm. And grade 4, it is more than 9 mm of overjet is present. Reverse, coming to reverse overjet, 0.1 to 1 mm of the reverse overjet is present. For grade 2, for grade 3, it is more than 1, so it is 1.1 to 3.5 mm. And for grade 4, there are two scenarios. One is it is more than 3.5. The reverse overjet is more than 3.5 millimeter, but there is no masticatory or speech difficulty. And the other one is 1.1 to 3.5, which is again same as grade 3, but with the speech and masticatory difficulty. So grade 5, it is more than 3.5 millimeter, but for grade 5 with the masticatory and the speech difficulty. Anterior or posterior crossbite is 1.1 to 2 millimeters for grade 2. For grade 3, same 1.1 to 2 millimeters. And between the retrograde contact position and intercuspal position. And grade 4, it is more than 2 millimeters. And also there is a posterior lingual crossbite present with the no functional occlusal contacts. There is displacement of teeth ranging from 1.1 to 2 millimeters for grade 2. For grade 3, it is 2.1 to 4 millimeters. And for grade 4, it is great or severe displacement of the teeth, more than 4 millimeters. There is an increase in the overbite. So it is more than or equal to 3.5 millimeters, but without gingival contact. For grade 3, it is increased or complete, but without any gingival trauma. For grade 4, it is increased or complete, but there is gingival or palatal trauma for grade 4. And same goes for grade 5, increase or complete with the gingival or palatal trauma. So lateral or anterior open bite is present ranging from 1.1 to 2 millimeters for grade 2. For grade 3, it is more than 2, so it is 2.1 to 4 millimeters. Both the anterior lateral or anterior open bite and the displacement of teeth are same for grade 2 and grade 3. So it is 1.1 to 2 millimeters for grade 2 and 2.1 to 4 millimeters for grade 3. And it is extreme open bite, and for grade 4 that is more than 4 millimeters. There are few extra features. For example, if there is partially erupted teeth present, or there is impacted or tipped teeth present, that comes under grade 4 requirement for orthodontic treatment. And if there is any supplemental teeth present, so that comes under grade 4. Coming to grade 5, if there is cleft lip or cleft palate patient, that comes under a very great requirement for orthodontic treatment. And any submerged deciduous teeth is present, that also comes under index of orthodontic treatment need. So this completes the index of orthodontic treatment need. And if you like our video, please press the like button. If you find our video informative, please share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel so that you get more videos like this. And stay tuned.